I'm joined now by Wisconsin's new volleyball coach, Kelly Sheffield. Congratulations and welcome to Madison. I guess the first question I've got for you, you're entering an elite conference for volleyball. How far away is Wisconsin from being an elite program again?
No, I think it's not as far as people think. I mean, I think the past, we've missed a tournament the last 5 years, but I think an argument can be made that every single one of those years, you're one win away from making it. You know, I just think you need to get some momentum. You know, it's got to start feeling good. Players need to start feeling good about themselves and the community, volleyball community and the fans that support this. I think, you know, you just got to kind of create a little bit of momentum. Recruits want to come here. I mean, they want to come here, and that's a big part of the battle is getting talent. Then you got to get that talent to believe in themselves. And I think once you create some momentum, this is a place where, you know, the sky's the limit.
Kelly, obviously you wanted to come here. Why?
Oh, man. This is an elite academic school. This is a top-notch. This is a great city to live in. It is the best volleyball conference in the country. And it's a school that really, really, they're all in and want to support. And they want to compete at that highest level. And they've got the tradition that says, hey, it can be done here. To me, this is the premier job in women's volleyball. And one that's just, it's on the edge. It's that sleeping giant that you hear. But this is true here. This is a sleeping giant that just, I think, is just bubbling and boiling and just ready to just go nuts. And to be a part of that and to hopefully help get us there, boy, that's exciting.
What's your first order of business with this program?
Well, I've been asked that, and what's one, what's two, what's three, and I don't think you've got a hundred things that you've got to do, and they're all just coming. You've got to get your staff and get them organized and bringing their families and understanding the roles and going through. There's been an unbelievable amount of people that have applied for this position. We've had about 200 people that are wanting to be on staff here. And you're trying to go through that. You're trying to connect with all of your current players and the recruits that are coming in. Then you're trying to get the ball rolling on recruiting. And, oh, yeah, you've got to bring your own family in and kind of manage that. So, and then the little things of just how UW works. You know, who do you go to ask different questions, and you know the compliance and everything that goes. So, it's 100 things that you're trying to manage. But at the meantime, you've got to get the players here, and you've got to be able to make those phone calls. And you know, we've had a lot of club people that have reached out to me so far that are really, really excited about building that relationship with me.
What's your first message to the players that you're inheriting?
You know, it's not just because I'm a new coach. It's like this: if I'll be here for 10 years, 20 years, it is, you're always looking forward, you know, and it doesn't matter what you've done in the past as a player, what your role has been. As a player on this team, it doesn't matter what the results were last year or the year before that. It's about getting better and moving forward. And so, you know, I want them to be excited about the future. I want them to know that it's to win in this conference and to win at the level that we're wanting to win at. It's really hard work, and they've got to be all the way in with this, with me and with the staff coming in. And then it's about excellence. It's not just about doing that out in the court, but it's also about, we've got to get better in the classroom. We've got to connect with the community and try to bring more of these great fans back in that have kind of left the past couple years. It's excellence across the board. It's going to be work, but hopefully the payoff will be a lot of fun.
Give us an idea what you visualize your team looking like on this floor.
Yeah, well, it's number one, I don't want anybody to question the work ethic, the passion that our team plays with. I mean, I want them to know this team is putting it all out there. We may not win every single night, but when fans leave here, that team, they put it all out there, and they did it with enthusiasm. They did it together. It's not about a system of play with me. I think what you try to do is you try to get great talent, and then you put that talent in positions where they can be successful. So you're kind of managing systems based on what you have rather than, all right, you players, you have to come to what I think is the ideal way of playing. You have to have great ball control. You've got to serve aggressively, and you've got to have some size and play power volleyball. But how the plays are working and what the offense is like, that's dependent on their strengths.
What are your expectations?
You keep getting better. You keep climbing the mountain. You keep, You make the choice to be extraordinary, to live extraordinary lives. You make that choice. It's a decision that you have to make, that I'm all in and I choose to be extraordinary. And that goes beyond just the court. That goes with your life. And I want our players to do that. If you make a daily choice of being extraordinary, you're all the way in. There's no limit, because this place, I don't think, has any limits of what it's capable of doing. You've got to be bought in, and you've got to be all the way in. It's not on your time. It's not when the sun is shining and things are going well. You are all the way in, and if you're doing that, things can get really, really good.
Look around. Do you have a feel what it might be like in here for a match?
Man, you're not. I've been, when I came here on my interview, the lights were out and they're having trouble getting the lights turned on here. And so I'm in here and my eyes are starting to get used to it, and it's dark and getting a little bit close. And then one light came on, and it was the one on the American flag, and everything else is dark, but you can kind of see things. And then more lights kind of came on, and it was kind of dramatic. I don't know if it was played or not, but it was, this is one of the great venues in college volleyball. I mean, it's awesome. This place, this lower bowl, is almost always packed. Boy, that first match, you know, it's all about putting it, you know, getting that team ready to go. But I'm sure there'll be a little bit of goosebumps coming out, and there should be. This place is a magical place.
You sound excited just talking about
it. I'm ready to go, guys. You know, yeah. It's, you hear it a lot, gold mine of a place. This is it. You know, I can't even tell you how many coaches I've heard from across the country is, man, this is a pretty good deal that you just walked into. And I'm like, you don't have to tell me. This is great. I've been here before. You know, when the Final Four was hosted here in Madison two times, I know what the fan support is like here. They've been great during the lean years. Hopefully we can get that turned around and we get this thing rocking again.
Nice meeting, and good luck this year, too.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching UWBadgers.com.